We are on the road again in our 200 square foot tiny house. We've done major upgrades on the interior, and now we get to put down the tools and have our first adventure. And this time around, we're a team of four. You got me, Kristen, Sia, Kai, and Atlas. We are starting our road trip on Manitoulin Island. Our journey begins with a 2-hour ferry from Tobermory to the southern side of the island on the infamous Chichimon.
Cool. Luna's never been on a boat.
Passengers have to take extra precaution during COVID, so a face mask is currently part of our travel essentials.
Because Atlas is with us, we actually can't hang out where all the other passengers are hanging out. We have this little area here. I feel like we're in a hospital waiting for something to happen. But it's still nice, it's private.
After a 2-hour boat ride, we made it, including Luna, to Manitoulin Island. And Sia and I, neither of us have been here before. We're going to be spending a week here, which I think is a nice amount of time to get out and explore this area. Anything that you want to add, Sia? This is like the largest... Wait, there's a stat that's like...
It's the largest freshwater island in the world.
It is the largest freshwater island in the world.
What's funny?
I forgot where I made a booking on this island. I booked here for a week, but I can't remember what RV park.
That's not that funny, really.
And I couldn't find it in my email.
But we know now, right?
No.
What?
No, I don't know. I have an idea of, like, the area, because I remember looking at that area, but I don't know. We're just gonna wing it.
Sia eventually remembered the name of the RV park, and after unhitching Luna, we went straight for lunch. I asked you guys on Instagram if you guys had any recommendations for places to eat, things to see, and I got a couple responses about this really amazing restaurant that is in an organic garden. You guys know me so well. It's not a banana, that's a squash. Oh, sorry, zucchini. Zucchini, it's a zucchini. Can you say that?
Zucchini.
That's right. This place is so us. It's this beautiful organic garden, huge garden.
No, dang it.
You want kombucha, okay. Kombucha break, a little bit, just a little bit, okay? Because it's got green tea, just a little bit. Pretty good, huh? Okay, let's have some soup. The food that they make here, they use as much from their garden as possible. Kai and I just took a walk through the garden. It's gorgeous. There's like zucchini. Oh, you want me to hold it? Grapes. All different types of lettuce and berries and things I've never heard of and herbs. Anyways, we're trying the soup. It's damn good. So good. I love finding places like this when we travel. Do you like it, Kai?
No, we have a potato pancake.
Ooh,
thank
perfect.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Look, we got lettuce from the garden, different lettuce, and cucumber from the garden. Hold on. Okay, go ahead. She wants it. Go for it, Kai.
Hey, Daddy.
Yeah. What do you have?
Cucumber.
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 Here's this one.
Oh my god, that's so good. Holy crap. And the lettuce and the relish and the tomatoes.
What else is in here?
And this is a lentil burger. I'm sure there's some ingredients that they grow here for that. But tastes so fresh. Sorry, I'm talking with my mouth full.
We were recommended to come here from one of you guys on Instagram. Told us to come to this restaurant, and thank you so much because I am obsessed already, and it's only been a one-time thing. We're here for a week. We're definitely coming back a few times. It's a family-run business. They have a massive organic garden, and all the food on their menu, a lot of it comes from their garden. So you're getting local, fresh ingredients, and you're also eating in the garden. So you're surrounded by the food that you're eating, which is just amazing. It's beautiful. It's a gorgeous day, and we just finished, and actually forgot, as usual, to like share it on Instagram, because I'm always like, going to this amazing restaurant, and then I forget to share it because the food is just so good, and I just forget because I'm occupied by, you know, good tasting food. Richard is the owner of Lobo Loco. He has been on the island for 10 years, and in 2013, he heard the alpaca farm was being sold, so he bought it.
We're seeing alpacas. This is your first time seeing alpacas.
Do you say alpaca?
He's amazed.
Let's go. Take my hand.
One, two.
There's so many.
So many. Don't kick me.
Yeah, I know.
It's like aimed right at me. They kick like a horse would? Like at the back?
They do that.
Which are finer than sheep's wool and hypoallergenic.
Yeah, okay.
The wool is lightweight and breathable.
This is so cool. And dry.
Unfortunately, the shop wasn't open just yet because of COVID. But we have a few alpaca blankets at home from our adventures in Ecuador, and they are so soft.
Hold your hand. Open your hand.
Well, just keep your hand out and I'll come to it.
Oh
my goodness, Kai, that's so cool.
Hold your hand.
His alpacas provide a local source of sustainable fiber products, creating artisan clothing from soft, durable fibers.
We just finished the llama experience, alpaca experience. And that was really fun. Kai, like, cried when we left.
She's still asking for llamas
right
now.
She loved them. And I can imagine that excitement, seeing a brand new animal for the first time, and traveling with a kid is amazing because it brings you back to that childlike state where everything was new and everything was exciting and wonderful. Manitoulin is an island, and within that island are lakes, and within those lakes are more islands. So there's a ton of lakes all around the island, and you can go to an island on a lake that's on an island, that's on a lake. I think that's pretty neat.
Try to wrap your head around that one.
Exactly. It really feels like we're far from home right now. I feel like a traveler, like a visitor of another place. Even though, you know, this is only a few hours from where we live, it still gives that same sensation of travel.
Just get out there and go to a place that you've never been to before, but it's only like an hour or two away from where you live.
I'm seeing a lot of farmers' fields. There's a lot of orchards. There's a lot of people, even on Instagram I saw, like, trading berries with each other and foraging on each other's land. There's a lot of history on this island. A lot of, like, fur trading hundreds of years ago. It was a big meeting spot for different natives in the area. It's pretty special to be here right now. I would love to come back for the powwow. They have a huge powwow
here every year. I think it might be one of the biggest in the country. And this year it didn't happen because, you know, people had to social distance, but I would love to come here.
Totally. Yeah. This whole island has a huge native culture. There's like a huge native population here. And as we're driving, we're seeing a lot of signs for different, like, native community centers and schools, shops, powwow, like, spots as well.
Yeah, totally.
That we read on the signs. So I'm very curious about the native culture. I don't really know too much. And, I live in Canada, and that's something that I feel like I should know more about. And I would really like to get that experience, but, like, a real authentic experience, not, like, a tourist experience. Their appreciation for the land and Mother Earth, and just like hearing them speak, as well as like their hardships and what they've gone through, which is crazy and still continue to go through. It's just, I'd like to be more informed about that.
Looking good.
Just hurt myself pretty bad.
Look, you're eating it. Watch your fingers.